Urgent action. Iranian human rights defender on hunger strike. Iranian human rights defender Narges Mohammadi, a prisoner of conscience, has been on hunger strike since 27th of June in protest at the authorities' persistent refusal to allow her to speak with her young children. As she suffers from several medical conditions and takes numerous medicines, the hunger strike critically endangers her health and life. Human rights defender Narges Mohammadi, a prisoner of conscience, started a hunger strike on 27th of June as a last resort to protest the judicial authorities' persistent refusal to allow her telephone contact with her nine-year-old twins. Her children had to move abroad 1 year ago to live with their father, as there was nobody to look after them in Iran after her arrest in May 2015. Since then, she has been allowed only one phone call with them. In a letter she wrote from inside Evin prison on 27th of June, announcing her hunger strike, she said that all her requests for telephone contact with her children have been refused, except on April 2nd, when on the written order of the Prosecutor General of Tehran, she was granted a 10-minute telephone call with them. She wrote, "I have forgotten their voices. I don't keep their photos by my bed anymore. I can't look at them. They have regarded me being a human rights defender as a crime, but more painful than that is that they have also denied my womanhood and my motherhood. Until the day I die and fall silent, I will continue protesting and I will never forget." Earlier in February 2016, Narges Mohammadi had written another open letter, this time to the head of the judiciary, expressing concern that the authorities were denying her telephone contact with her children to further punish her. Narges Mohammadi is critically ill. She suffers from a pulmonary embolism, a blockage in the blood vessel that carries blood from the heart to the lungs, and a neurological disorder that has resulted in her experiencing seizures and temporary partial paralysis. She needs ongoing specialized medical care, which she cannot receive in prison, as well as daily medication, and a hunger strike puts her health and life at risk. On July 3rd, she was taken from Tehran's Evin prison to Iran Mehr Hospital, also in Tehran, for routine tests related to her pulmonary embolism. She has received a 16-year prison sentence after she was convicted following an unfair trial in April 2016 of the charges of founding an illegal group, gathering and colluding to commit crimes against national security, and spreading propaganda against the system. She's already serving a 6-year prison sentence from a previous case. Her conviction is based solely on her human rights work. I'm just going to add that basically her human rights activism has been spreading the word against injustice that has been happening in prison. She's been the defender of many prisoners. When she was, you know, outside prison, she was a great defender of human rights of prisoners, for Sunnis, Christians, Baha'is, prisoners of conscience, political prisoners. She was an advocate for persecution and people on death row. She did many, many steps towards achieving that goal of abolishing executions. So when you look at the history of her activism, there's not even one action that has been, you know, against people or against the government. She is a follower of love, peace, and unity. And she has also said that what I'm teaching my children is not revenge, is not hate. It's action towards love, unity, and peace.
I would also like to acknowledge that we have our MLA, Selena Robinson, here with us today.
It is a horrible thought that when you stand up for something that you believe is right and that puts you in prison, and that because you're in prison, you don't get to speak to your children. I'm a mom too, and I can't imagine. I too have taught my children to speak up. God gave them 2 ears and 1 voice. They're to use both, but to listen twice as much as they speak. But I want them to use their voice. And I cannot imagine a place where many of you have come from where you can't use your voice. So it's for this reason that I joined all of you, because I think we all have a responsibility to speak up, to use our voice so that others can use theirs. Thanks for everything that you do to bring these voices and these stories here to one of the best places to live.
And now, Fred, if you'd like to come up and say a few words.
I'm glad Selena is here, and also I asked our Member of Parliament, Tim Downing, to be here, but unfortunately he's on a trip, and he said, send my regard, but I won't be able to attend today. So one important thing is, we make our politicians, like Selena, like Finn, and everybody else from any party, to know our concern. Because what is happening, we have a new federal government, which they are just talking, they said, you know, Iran, you know, but I think they are going to work more economic benefit than human rights. So we have to let them know human rights is a priority to economic relations with Iran. I love to see embassy open in Iran, but embassy open not just for profit of economic relations, but for observing the human rights. And also, I would like to mention, there are many political and conscious prisoners in Iran that are not known. Ms. Mohammadi is well known, you know, everybody knows her, and it's great we were working to release her, which is perfect. But there are many, many other ones which nobody knows their name. They are being murdered, they are being tortured, they are being imprisoned, and don't even know who they are. So let's find out who they are, bring that attention, their name to the amnesty, to your MP, to your MLA, you know, be active in this community. And I think if you are active in this community, there's many things you can do.
There are petitions up here to sign and some urgent action information to take. So I would really encourage you to sign the petitions. We will gather up all those signatures. They'll go back to Amnesty International in Ottawa. They'll gather them from around the world, and they'll put our voices together, and we'll make a powerful statement amongst all of us. I'd also like to acknowledge that MP Ron McKinnon also sent his regrets, and he is away out of town, so couldn't be here as well. One last thing is that we have some cake up here, because we did have some good news, and this is a little bit of a celebration about Narges's hunger strike being over. So I hope you'll come up and join, have a piece of cake, sign the petitions, and talk to each other. And I encourage you again to either join an amnesty group or to go online and sign some petitions and send some letters. Thank you.